Welcome to Discovery Garden Pattaya. My name is Hans Fritschi. Today I'm going to talk about the baobab. This is a gigantic tree and the most well-known comes from Africa. And if you follow me over here, you can see what a beautiful, huge tree it is. Huge, big, big. Look at this. Look at this. I mean, it's impossible to reach around. It's so huge. It's a real giant. But would you believe me that those baobabs here have exactly the same age as the big fellow? They are now about 9 years old. And what's the difference? About 7 years ago, we planted this baobab in the ground and it has really taken off. Look at those roots. They are vast and there is one going down as well. Whereas those with the same age were contained like in a straight jacket and the roots could not go out. They were kept like bonsais. I show you more of those. Okay, here we have some more of these baobabs. Look at those. And they have even destroyed their concrete rings. They want to live, they want to grow. And just recently, one of them fell down and we removed it to another location because the baobabs are individuals also. You have seen the smaller ones, the same age, 9 years of age, but these ones here, they love it. Of course, they get a lot of sun and that helps them too. And they want to outgrow their prison. Okay, we are now in front of that baobab that fell down. We moved it here. You can see the roots are now all covered with a lot of dirt, or it should come back. There are signs of life. It had to be cut badly. It was so heavy. Three people could not carry this tree. It had to be dragged by the pickup. Otherwise, we could not have moved it. And if we move or sell the other ones over there, we need probably a crane to get them out of the ground and to put on a six-wheel drive or a 10-wheel drive. And but it's coming back. Baobabs are really difficult to kill, but I will show you one that got killed, or maybe not. On the way to the baobab in the back part, we have seen one of our iguanas, and it's a small one. Normally we have bigger ones that are reach 1.5 meters. This is still halfway a baby. And he is afraid a bit. He's walking away from us now. We just need him now. We are now at that baobab alley. If you look down there, there are about 10 baobabs in a row. And I will show you an especially interesting one over there. Okay, you see, this baobab fell down. Why did it fall down? It's really difficult to kill a baobab, but we succeeded almost here. It's only that you can kill a baobab if it stands over a prolonged period of time in clogged water. This the roots cannot support. And we built a walkway here, and here was like a swamp in the rainy season. This fell down about two years ago, and we just left it. And we hope that it's not completely gone, because there are several small baobabs now growing from this stem. And maybe one day this will look absolutely fantastic. But what we also have to do, we have to cut back all that bamboo we planted in this area. It takes the light. Baobabs need sun, and it takes out the light. Look at this great bamboo we have here. This is really gigantic bamboo. Or over here, the bamboo has a whitish color. And here you see another baobab that almost fell down, but we cut it back and it's going up straight now, and we hope that it will recover. We are quite sure this will happen, but we have to get rid a bit of that bamboo, even though it's very beautiful. You see, this is black bamboo, very hard to find, very seldom found. And we have a big one over there, a big one over here, but we have to cut them back a little bit to enable life for this African baobab. Okay, here we see some more of these baobabs. There's some buff here, but easy to take out. And they make like a walkway here. They shade very well. Look at this, follow me. This looks also quite nice. We have, I don't know how many baobabs we have. We have at least 30 planted in Discovery Garden Pattaya, and some only so far in Discovery Garden Nong Khai. You know, my first baobab I saw in Brazil. And that's actually absolutely the wrong place, because there were no baobab types in the New World, in the Americas. But the African one, the Adansonia digitata, the most famous one, this one, was planted in Brazil because people are interested in that too. And there are altogether 9 baobab types. One, as I said, from Africa, this type. Then we have one from Australia, and 7 alone from Madagascar. And we have managed here to get 7 out of the 9 baobab types. I will show you. We are now near a baobab type that comes from Madagascar. It's a very rare baobab. It's actually on the red list. It's highly endangered. It's the Adansonia perrieri. And would you believe, very beautiful tree also. A darker bark than the Adansonia digitata, and growing very quickly. Would you believe me that we planted this baobab from Madagascar only a year ago, a little bit over a year ago, and it was about 1 meter high, and it has grown tremendously in that very short time. There are more over here. They are the same type. you see here in the foreground, but also in the background, and they are absolutely stunning baobabs. Okay, this baobab type comes from Australia. It's Adansonia gregori, and it was planted exactly at the same time as the Adansonia perrieri, the Madagascar baobab that you just saw. And if you follow me over here, oh, what do I see? What do I see? What a surprise! This is a strawberry guava. They are really delicious. Ah, I think I eat it right now. Mmm, sweet and sour. Wonderful. And such nice leaves also. There are more fruits over here. But what we are really talking about is the individuals in tree. This is also Adansonia gregori, which means it's also an Australian baobab, the same type as you have seen before. And why are they so different in height? It's individual. Plants are also individuals. Some are powerful, some are very weak. This one apparently is very weak. This one is relatively powerful. I mean, you cannot compare the two types together, but they are, the Australian baobabs, they are far smaller than the ones from Madagascar. But you can compare that one with this one, and then this one is the victor. So this is, in a way, my baobab nursery. You know, I got the seeds, sometimes they are very bad and won't germinate, and sometimes they are okay, but it's a very expensive business to do or to get them. Now this is another Adansonia suaracensis, also a baobab from Madagascar. I got three of that type. Then here is the nursery Adansonia madagascariensis, also rather smaller ones. This one is the powerful one from Madagascar, perrieri, that you have seen already. And if we go in here, then you see the Adansonia ruprostipar, also doing okay, but not as powerful as the other ones. And last but not least, we have the Adansonia grandidieri, also from Madagascar. And you see, there are such a variety of these giant trees, and we will take all these types we have. We have 7 out of 9 types. We will also take to Nongkai Garden and plant them there. But presently you can see most baobabs at Discovery Garden Pattaya. Normally we do some eating. Okay, I had a strawberry guava, a delicious one, but baobabs also produce edible fruits. So far, from all our trees, we had one single fruit edible, but the chipmunks stole it and ate it. So we don't know yet how the baobab fruit tastes. Anyway, this is an installment all about baobabs, 9 types. 7 are to be found at Discovery Garden Pattaya, and soon Discovery Garden Nongkai. If you liked what you saw, please join in and subscribe to the Hans Fritschi channel on YouTube or Hans Fritschi Friends on Facebook. And bye bye!